Shinsuke was in my brain a little bit. But yeah, I'll be doing that because it already relieved the stress just a little bit. But I'll be doing that all day. Hello, I'm Jeff Hardy with The Wrestling Show.
Okay. Yeah. I will call and let you
know. Okay. Thank you.
I'm Jeff Hardy with The Wrestling Show.
Big wrestling show tonight.
What is a Hell in a Cell in your words?
Hell in a Cell in my words is the ultimate match that I've always wanted to be a part of. I think for the last 8 or 9 years, I've probably talked about that's one thing on my bucket list to do, and here we are. First time I've ever seen a red Hell in a Cell. That's wow. Wow, I can't believe it's red. This is wild.
Very cool.
Oh my gosh, that's high.
Preparing for Hell in a Cell is basically watching a lot of video of Hell in a Cell. And over the years, I've noticed it's changed dramatically. It seems like it's a lot taller now than it was in 2010. All I got is what I see inside my mind as far as what it's going to be like when that door is locked and I'm trapped in there with Randy Orton. So I'm sure it's going to be quite different than what I expected.
I went to sleep with butterflies, woke up with butterflies. I'm pretty sure they're going to be multiplying throughout the day until this match is over. But it's the good kind of butterflies, you know, the kind of the adrenaline rush I live for. To be here on this day, the day of, is kind of surreal, especially with a red Hell in the Cell. Like, I never expected that. When I walked in and saw that thing, I was like, whoa, this is dreamlike for sure. And to actually get inside it for the first time in my life, it's a lot more intimidating than I thought. And I was thinking about this last night also. I'm going, okay, and I'd watched some TLC matches doing cardio or something the day before, and I was like, wow, these are insane, immortal, they'll never get old, they will always be cool. And then I'm going, wait a minute, you just turned 41 years old and you're about to do your first Hell in a Cell, so. Like 20 years later, after you were the 20-year-old, you know, Jeff Hardy in there doing extremely impressive things. And here I am, you know, yeah, 20 years later, like trying to be just as impressive. So, I think it makes it more exciting, if anything else. If I can go out there and put on a good show and give the people what they want to see Jeff Hardy do, then I'll be extremely proud of myself after this is all over. My whole career has been about days like this, and so for the people to still kind of be digging what Jeff Hardy's doing, I mean, it's great. And I know everything I've seen about Hell in a Cell, it's like when you're talking about Mick Foley, and when my name is brought into the picture, okay, they're the ones that are going to do something stupid. To me, it's not stupid at all. It's opposite. I think it's a life wish and more genius than anything.
Being in WWE right now in 2018, you know, 41 years of age, and it's just it feels right. I mean, and I know this is, you know, where Matt and I started back in, I think we signed developmental deals in 97, 98, something like that. And anyway, it started a long time ago, and it was only right for us to come back and end it where it started. So, and that's what I'm looking forward to as far as when people mention, you know, future Hall of Famer. I never really, I don't, you know, consider myself that, or I don't think about that a lot, but the fact that we probably will be Hall of Famers is pretty cool, and I want to do the best I possibly can, and it's just amazing for things to be going so good right now, for WWE to be standing behind me through thick and thin, and for me, I hope I'm giving it back and making up for all the wrongs. The only thing that limits you is your imagination, and I think that's what was said, and so I think I'm good to go with that, because my mind is going crazy with thoughts and, you know, the good and the bad, the right and the wrong. That's probably the scariest thing for the fans watching me, because sometimes my thoughts are too big for my size. I have a limit. I'm not exactly sure what that is, but there's definitely a line drawn. But the thing is, when you get out there in front of the WWE universe and the adrenaline starts flowing, I tend to forget all that and forget that I am limited in what I do, because their energy is superhuman to me. The face paint is something that I just, you know, when I don't have time to paint on canvas at home because the WWE schedule is so brutal, you know, as you know, I mean, it's just, it's an outlet as far as I can get to the building and have this image in my head, and being that I don't have a canvas, I can just use my face as what I want to try to bring to life. When I am all painted up, it's like I kind of feel like it's my alien skin. What does my soul look like when it gets out of this body and I'm on a star looking back at Earth and all these crazy thoughts, and will I, you know, look like an alien? All these artistic thoughts come into mind. Like, it shows artistic freedom and also freedom of your soul. It's like expression at its best. And I think I am a little more sociable when I'm all painted up. I think I feel normal, quite normal, a lot more normal than when I'm all shy and not painted. That's Jeff Hardy, the charismatic enigma at his best, when he comes out with the face paint. The face-painted freak, man, I mean, that's by far a compliment in my book. Wrestling is still an outlet for me creatively. It's the way I express myself best, I think, especially for the public to see and witness each and every week and all across the world. I mean, people that are familiar with Jeff Hardy and what it's like to see him perform, I mean, I just want to be the best I can this later in life and stay on this role that I'm on and do it for as long as I can. Pro wrestling to me is an art form, and it forever will be, and I'll never take myself too seriously. And it is a creative outlet and a creative freedom to express each and every week, and it's so cool to still be doing that. Mentally, before a big match like this, I mean, it's draining. But like, once it gets started, like once the bell rings and what happens in between, I mean, it all it's almost dreamlike. It's not like I've been there before or something. Like I was meant to do this, because I guess I've seen it so many times in my head that I wanted to do a Hell in a Cell for so long. And it kind of feels like I've been there before. The only way to explain it is to survive it, and when it's over, you can look back and just be so proud on what you've created and what you've survived.
Is there any fear?
There's a little fear, but you know, that's part of the fun. If there was no fear, there's no, you know, tremendous payoff in it all, because fear is part of the fun. I do it for the glory.